Today on The Brief, tell me if you've heard this one before. A municipal government gets attacked with ransomware. Against all logic, it pays off the criminals. Citizens whose taxes pay for all of this do nothing because it's no big deal to them. Days later, another headline in another city. I'm sure you have heard that, and I'm hoping you're as fed up with this as I am. As ransomware attacks against all levels of government continue to increase in both frequency and intensity, we're long overdue for a reckoning in government IT. The latest 1-2 punch happens in Infotech's backyard. Earlier this month, the Canadian city of Stratford, Ontario, admitted it paid a $75,000 ransom in Bitcoin after hackers infiltrated its systems. The incident happened back in April, and the city sat on this news for 5 months before going public. So why did it pay? Because its insurer said it should. As soon as the headlines faded in Stratford, nearby Woodstock confirmed its emails and core municipal systems were also taken down by a targeted attack. Worse, the city couldn't even explain how it was infected. But we can. We've seen these scenarios play out time and again. And in most cases like these two, it's an ill-trained employee who clicks on a rogue link or a button in a rogue email. And that's when the fun begins. Of course, cities like Stratford and Woodstock could easily shrug off a ransomware attack if their data were properly backed up, and if they were regularly testing their restore capabilities, if they routinely drilled their teams in recovery, if they applied the same rigor to protection against cyber attacks as they do against, say, major storms or floods or fires or anything else that merits its own section in a DRP. But they don't, and that needs to change. We recently published a research note you'll want to read called "Are Cyber Attacks Like Natural Disasters?" It's both the title of the note and a really good question. The short answer is yes, a cyber attack is indeed like a natural disaster. The scenario needs to be baked into every disaster recovery plan. And if it isn't, then stakeholders have every right to ask why. That's food for thought.